This is not how I imagined my first day.
Hello there guys, welcome to the channel, and instead of a satirical video like last time, I'm actually going to do a proper analysis of the AI and enemies in Resident Evil 2's remake. So this is going to show you everything to do with the AI and how difficult the game may actually play out to be, because to be honest, Capcom did quite a bad job at giving implications off about that when they did their E3 footage. As you can see from the gameplay here, it looks like the person's intentionally setting themselves up to be ganked, as well as the fact that they're firing at the body parts, but we all know the T-virus, and it's the head that is the critical point to shoot at in order to take a zombie down. However, a lot of people were thinking Capcom were doing these things intentionally, as I said, to draw the difficulty into a higher tier and make it look like it's something more than it actually is. But be rest assured, I do want to say that most of the people that do these demonstrations are honestly just bad at games. I'm not sure why they pick them up specifically, and I will be providing a lot of analysis over the enemies and AI in this video. Capcom didn't actually do the best demonstration themselves, funnily enough, so I hope this video is informative and helps you to know how difficult the game is going to be. Now, the first thing I'm going to pick up on is the fact that, of course, like I said, you have to shoot zombies in the head. This is kind of a standard knowledge in kind of all zombie genre games, to be honest, not just Resident Evil, but we do have a lot of information related about the T-virus and about how the brain is the center point to shoot at. Now, because of the third person angle perspective, people were obviously questioning whether Capcom were intentionally doing this, but look at some of this footage here and you can see other people shooting at the heads, and it does take up a plethora of large amounts of rounds to take out some of the zombies, even when all of them are center fired straight into the brain. Even shotgun rounds, if not perfectly placed into the upper torso and head, can take zombies down in one shot, so be rest assured the amount of damage resistance the enemy has is incredibly high. Also, the enemies will constantly grasp after you, search for you, and even follow you through doorways, which obviously wasn't present due to technical limitations back in the day. However, now they will just walk through the doors themselves, no loading screens necessary, another great feature. You'll have to stay on your toes heavily, and there does seem to be a significant damage model, as well as the fact they are bringing back the ability for zombies to get back up, even after you initially thought you had killed them. Now, there was some footage of this present that was shown, and this is something that is very important to know, because zombies might actually look like they've died, and you'll see this here as I show on screen. You're basically seeing the zombies play a very elaborate game of fake death, and they will get back up, they will try to attack you, they will take a lot of bullets to fully finish off, and this just further provides you quite an idea of how enduring the zombies are, because the amount of ammunition used in just this one encounter with a single zombie is absolutely staggering, and there are scenes where there is literally quite a number of zombies coming at you at once, as well as the fact that it looks like the enemies are going to be constantly hoarding their ways through the windows and reinforcing the numbers of the lost zombies. Now, there was multiple scenes of this, and these were not windows that you could board up, so I'm just going to assume you're going to be under a constant crusade of attack in the Raccoon City Police Department, and there's never going to be a sense of safety where you've actually taken all the enemies out. Now, this makes sense now why the gunpowder system's being put in, as well as handgun ammunition being more prominent, because enemies are going to be much more difficult. So it does seem like Capcom were being true to their word. The game isn't just going to be some easy joyride, and the enemies are going to be quite difficult. The E3 footage we saw wasn't misleading. They weren't just running into ganks on purpose and shooting the zombies in the body to make themselves look bad and make the game look hard. The game is definitely going to be very difficult, and the enemies have got a very large amount of resilience, and I think we've completely proven that point, so let's move on to another one now. It looks like there's going to be some kind of dynamic damage system in the game, and as you can see here, the zombie was basically crippled, and Leon starts getting ankle bitten, a very, very effective attack if I must say so myself, but also considering the amount of zombies laying around, it's going to keep you in constant paranoia. But it looks like the modular damage system from the latest Resident Evils is making a comeback. It wasn't so much there in Resident Evil 7 due to the unique nature of the mold, but the T-virus zombies are definitely going to show that off. You'll also be able to shoot off their arms to impede their ability to grapple you, and there will be ways to dodge through the enemies as well, which I did show in my previous video. So all in all, it looks like there's a lot of ways to mess around with the enemy and change the combat flow up, but this also means that you'll have to stay on your toes, even more so than the original Resident Evil 2 by a large margin. So that third person camera change didn't make everything easy. All of these different iterations and things that they've put in have actually probably made the game more difficult. And remember, we're just tackling regular zombies at the moment. We haven't even discussed anything else, and we don't know how that AI is going to work out. But based on how lethal we've shown everything up to now, I'm only assuming we're gonna get skewered. Considering that a lot of people were very, very worried whether Resident Evil 2 would remain faithful to the old series, here's another pointer as to why it is. There will be zombies laying around the environment, and these may seem inanimate at first. You can even gain ammunition from them, but they will attack and gank you if you do decide to just leave them alone. So you'll have to be very cautious around every single corpse you encounter, even the inanimate ones that are just laying around the area. It looks like the RPD section is going to take up quite a large amount of time, and even in just this short area, there's going to be quite a huge amount of relentless attacks that you have to constantly defend yourself against. It also looks like the enemies can now clamber across the environment, as you can see, and I'll demonstrate this in quite a funny little clip here with some good subtitles, as I know you guys enjoy those. Very much so.
Don't you dare! Get back!
What the hell?
Fuck! Fucking hell! Stop it! Damn it.
Now this is the only one I could actually find at the moment, but there does seem to be references to the fact that the T-virus zombies still retain some level of humanity and some of their old memories as documented throughout various games. As you can see here, one of the officers is actually slamming on a vending machine. It's obviously a joke to obese cops as well, but it is also a little Easter egg and nod to those that know about the T-virus's effects on the brain and the fact that in some individuals, portions of their former humanity remain, and this is even prominent with some other viruses as well, such as the G virus with Lisa Trevor from Resident Evil 1. Now, I couldn't capture any footage of this, I just remember seeing it at some point, and it is an additional point I want to make that is kind of nice. But if you do defeat a zombie and then that zombie actually shuffles into Leon, even though it's dead, Leon will still react to it, he'll be pushed aside by it, and it's actually kind of a nice aesthetic and immersive touch that just adds to the value. As well as this, the blood from the zombies will spray on his outfit, and weather effects also seem to have an effect on Leon in real time, affecting the wetness of his outfit and his hair, as you can see demonstrated in this clip here. Anyway guys, it's been lovely talking about the AI and analyzing things here. I'm sure there are some things that I've definitely missed out, so if you do notice anything that I haven't, please leave a comment below and let everybody know so the community can sprout and we have as much information as accessible to us for when the game finally releases on January the 25th, 2019. If you have enjoyed the video, please do leave a like and a subscribe. It would really help the channel grow and I'm trying to get out there, and I'll keep you up to date with as much information on Remake 2 as I can. I'm watching a ton of content and there is a lot to go through, as well as additional interviews from the developers themselves. But for now, I just hope you're having a beautiful day. As always, take it easy and peace.